Welcome back to the second part of our Delta Force Extreme 2 let's play. Right now we are loading the second mission, it's called Barricade. As our weapon screen looks a bit different than the last time. M4. Should I take this M16? Another briefing. Okay, we secured an armed boat and we have to clear the shores of the river. Okay.
King 6 to Bravo. We have a confirmed position on our bird about 2 clicks north.
50 caliber.
Be advised, heavy enemy presence in the village ahead.
Roger, King 6, confirming enemy presence. Proceed with caution, over.
It's a bit jumpy.
Coming rounds, clear to engage, open
under
fire.
Ow. Red crosshair, that was a hit. Another hit. Another hit.
Nice shot,
that's
keep
good.
Their heads down, keep it in there. Incoming fire!
Ooh.
Okay, I think it's safe to assume anything moving is hostile.
Those are paper boats. Another one.
There's RPG on that boat, take him out before they flank us.
RPG is on the boat. Oh. Guard tower. I love that practically everything is
nice job, Bravo.
Capable to explode here. Enemy chopper.
Oh yeah.
Every little house and every little hood can explode. Makes this jump a little bit easier. Oh, boat.
Got movement up ahead. Check those huts off the bow. Incoming fire!
I think my gun is overheating.
Remove that armored barge in a blocking position. Take out the gunners and bridge crew.
Oh, RPG. Oh my god. Jeep. I can't see something. Okay. Another one. And he walked away. Got him.
Take out the gunners and bridge crew.
Next one. Oh god, how many are those? I said in the first part the artificial intelligence is pretty dumb and they made up for that with lots and lots of enemies. Those enemies might be dumb. They are dumb enough to stand behind a rock and trying to shoot through that rock, but they are very good marksmen. Sometimes they can hit with an AK-47 over a mile with the first shot. Okay. Die.
Okay.
Now he tells me. After I wasted my RPG.
Stay underwater until you reach the shore. Possible snipers.
Thanks for the warning. Oh. Oh. Gotcha. Oh. Another one? Ah. Rats. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, next round. There he is. still shooting. Oh. Oh. On the bridge. Ah. Ah. Same place. Different shooter. This game has some bullet drop, it has ballistics integrated, but I think they tried to go for a real... Oh, what's that? Is that a boat? Bridge for boat? I think they went for kind of the real bullet drop. You have 100 or 150 meters and you can barely see the bullet drop. Unlike the Battlefield series, the later Battlefield series, where the bullet drop is kind of over exaggerated. So that you have to actually count it in on the small maps. Maps in Battlefield are maybe 1 or 2 kilometers wide.
Air support's finally here.
And you... They had to scale it down a bit. Okay. C4. That's always great. Oh, another one. No, if we can go... no. Better not risk... slamming onto the boat or this... little ship here. What is this? Doesn't make sense. Okay, now the old game. Select the right weapon. Okay, in there, and it goes. Remember the big blast radius? Smoke grenade, flashbang, frag, M4, pistol, knife, detonator. Detonator. Yeah.
So, nice job, Bravo.
Back on board. Checkpoint. Hey, wait. Aha. I should not have done this. Fuck. So where is he going? Let's see if I can outrun him. I don't really know why the gun, the primary gun, is... oh, he's waiting, that's fine. Adjusted to the right of the screen and the pistol is adjusted in the middle. A little bit Doom style. I mean, I kind of like it because it's kind of a retro feel right there. Oh, hi!
Watch the dogs.
This is my caliber 50 knocking device. I'm going through the town and knocking on every door. Everything is flammable. That's a good idea. If you set up a camp in the middle of the jungle or and you're waiting some spec ops to come in and steal something from you or destroy something from you, make everything flammable. Your boats, your huts, even your wooden watchtowers or sandbags, fortified positions. Always good to have everything flammable.
Alright, I'm gonna drop you off just up ahead. Hit the shore and link up with a downed air crew. Yes. Good luck, Bravo.
Oh. Did you take a hit? What kind of noise is that? Some of my squad mates had too much broccoli? Do they have gas or something? Oh! That's not very nice. It's disturbing. I wonder if it's possible to use bedrock. Bedrock. Die. I wonder if it's possible to use this engine for a modern game. I said it in the other first part. That why is he shooting on the rock? It's shooting on the rocks. Shooting on the rocks. Sounds like a very bad drink. Oh. But maybe... I think some RPG would be... Oh. Surface to air missiles. That's that noise. I see you. Must be a nest or something like that. A hedgehog. Enemies are pretty stupid, but you see that they, the bullets are coming in pretty near, and I only need one or two. I don't need, I don't have any more hit points than my enemies. That's what it makes so different, difficult, different and difficult. Okay, die. Oh. Can't see you. This is kind of fascinating. This is a very clean surrounding compared to modern games. You don't have many objects, you don't... even the grass is kind of... yeah, you can kind of... It's a stupid position. Why in the earth would you fortify this? Why not? So I would never fortify this. Corner. Neighbors are loud again. I think I'm going to go up and ask them to turn down their music. What's the... Oh, oh, no. The sandbags are placed very stupid. Very stupid way. Yeah, the surroundings are very clear, and your enemies aren't able to sneak up on you. That's the interesting part. Got him? Okay, got him. Two. Oh! Oh, I didn't see you. Okay. The waypoint spawning is a good idea. Yeah. So you have this wide open maps and this pretty open area where you can decide on how you get to your targets and how you're going to sneak up on your objectives. But on the other hand, you can cross those waypoints, and if you get shot, you still don't have to run the whole way back. It's actually a pretty good thing. One of the problems on big open maps is always the respawn system if you die, if there is a respawn system in place. Many RPGs, you are just simply respawn in front of an instance or in a specific place, a specific house. Sound is quite unnerving. Okay, let's try the other side this time. Ha! Can I run up here? Oh yeah, I can run up here. Ooh. Oh. Okay, it's shooting at my mate there. Oh. Oh. What was that? Oh, spot waypoint reached. That's great. Sam launchers destroyed. Black Widow's inbound. Black Widow's inbound. That's something I really love to hear or read. All objectives completed. Black Widow. There he is. Why is he shooting? Oh, he's clearing the landing zone for me. Nice of him. Not my best round, I have to admit. Okay. There's the Alpha Squad, doing nothing the whole time. We're providing cover. The foot of this hill. Stop shooting at me. Okay, hop aboard. Sit. Oh. Butler to the airport. Make it fast, I have to catch a plane. We cleared the barricade in this mission. Barricade. I died a few times. So this game manages to tell a story with some very simple objectives on, on the maps, and is even able to do this without any video content or without any render sequences. And so on. Okay, that was the second mission.